there. Welcome back to Studio 10. It is time to play the $5 quiz, but before we can do that, we need some special audience members to help fill out this amazing ride. So let's have a look here. Who wants to be in it? Oh my goodness. Is that Emily and Matt? Emily and Matt from the Good morning to you.
Good morning.
Emily.
Good morning.
This is just a thrill. You just never know who is going to be in the Studio 10 audience. Wow, you guys, thank you so much for joining us. Do you mind having a go at the $5 quiz?
We'd love to.
No, that's the right answer. Emily,
Are you making your mind up? Okay, all right, good.
Now, Emily, you've absolutely dominated the backstroke in the Australian Champions this week, winning so much. How has it been for you?
Yeah, it's been really good. It was a great meet, and I did a couple of PBs, which I'm really happy about.
Now, for those playing at home, what's a PB?
Personal best.
Personal best.
Sorry.
I'm always a little bit rusty on the sports terms as well. Now, what's been your highlight?
I don't know. I think the great competition that we had this week has been really good, and it's really shown how far we've moved forward.
Mm-hmm. Now, it's been a tense 15 metres with you, hasn't it? With Cameron and, is it Matt?
Cameron and James. Cameron and James. Do you like each other?
Yeah, we do. Mm. Yeah, yeah. We, like, not when we're racing, because that'd be counterproductive, but, yeah, we do. We're good friends.
All right, and we're going to be good friends today. Have a seat up on the game zone here.
Get ready for Australia's richest prize pool. One of our contestants will win $5 Australian as we play Studio 10's The $5 Quiz. Now, please welcome your quizmaster, David Robinson.
Thank you so much.
Hello, everyone, and welcome to the $5 Quiz on a beautiful Friday morning. We have got some very special contestants, so let's meet them right away. Deborah Hutton, good morning to you.
$5. I'm right on the buzzer here.
Have you already thought what you're going to pay? What are you going to buy, with your $5?
What was that?
What are you going to buy with your $5?
Oh, what is actually worth now? I just came back from the States. It's worth about $1.50. Yeah.
You can get about half a cup of coffee at Sydney Airport.
That's about right, too.
There's no guarantee you'll be able to keep it. They sometimes take it.
Thank you, Arthur.
That's
she's
actually
on
true.
To you guys.
Arthur's run it, Arthur's won it twice, and we've taken it off her both times. Sorry, Arthur. We still remain friends, though, haven't we?
Just.
Oh. Okay, moving right along, Joe Hildebrand, good morning to you.
Hi, good morning.
Now, I want this to be your week this week. It just has to be.
Yeah, I think I'm due for a win. Obviously, I haven't actually won a game since ever.
Yep.
So I think as soon as, you know, maybe Ida stops hogging it, maybe I can...
You'll get it, you'll get it. One person who has got it before, but not quite, is Sarah Harris.
I gave my money away.
You did. You're a beautiful woman. Thank you for joining us here this morning. Ida Buttrose, good morning to you. Okay, and now are you ready to play the $5 quiz?
Oh, I am.
Yeah, have you dried off?
Yeah. Let's not bring that up.
Okay.
The back is still a bit wet, but you can't see it.
I'll take some points off her if you like.
Thank you.
Yeah, I will do that.
Take five.
Yeah. Okay. Now, a very special audience member is Matt Abood. Good morning to you. And good morning to Emily Seabon.
Good morning. Yay!
All right. Let's get into it. Now, each correct answer is worth 1 point in round one. Let's begin now. What? Well, no, we can't afford that. We can't afford that. Here we go.
Hang on.
Oh, yeah, there we go. Sorry.
Sorry for talking back.
What Ita says, no. Ita gets.
Wetting Ita.
Here we go. What is Kylie Minogue's lingerie line called? Matt. Oh, okay. Wow.
I don't know. Kylie?
No, it's called Love Kylie.
You should be so lucky.
You should be. Locomotion, bit of locomotion. All right. How many years did the 100-year war last?
100.
Incorrect, it was 115.
Right.
Yep. What is a pregnant goldfish called? Joe Hildebrand.
Well, if I'm going to know that.
Why do you use the buzzer then?
Well, everyone else was doing it.
Does anyone else want to have a go? Anyone else want to have a go? A pregnant goldfish.
Fat Goldie.
No, it's a twerp. A twerp.
A twerp?
Oh,
really?
You're a pregnant goldfish.
Oh, I don't know what you're doing. All right, here we go. Name the strongest muscle in the body.
Oh! Actually, I can't say.
Gluteus maximus.
Oh, no, no, no. In some it is.
Sounded anyone impressive, else though.
It's something that's hidden in a man's pants.
Oh. Maybe in some of them, but not all of them. It would be the strongest muscle in the body is a tongue.
Oh, yes, it is.
Oh. Yeah, okay, yeah. Wow. You learn something every day? Yeah. All right. What is the dot above the eye called? In the alphabet, the dot above the eye.
Or dot.
No, it's close. It's called a tittle. A tittle.
Oh.
Yeah. Name the only land mammal that can't jump.
Sarah. White men.
White men.
That's 2 points. I'm going to give you 2 points for that, Sarah Harris. Oh, that was very good.
You and I.
Very good.
Now,
the first puck used in the game of ice hockey. Sorry, the first puck used in the game. Okay, I can't even read it here. What was the first puck made out of? My talent?
Puck you.
No. Oh.
Well, I haven't won for a while, you know.
I think you should take some points off it from that.
Yeah, I'm going to take points. That's 1 point off
it's
you.
It's rubber.
It was actually cow manure.
Oh, no.
Was the first puck, yeah. The first puck. We're going to do a quick score check here. Deborah is on -1, Joe -2, Sarah -1, Ita -1, Mac -2. Emily's really the winner at the moment. You can be the winner if you're on zero. Now, coming up after the break, we are going to play the very important Fast Money round here on the $5 quiz. It's kind of anyone's game. I don't know how it's going to be. But Emily is our champ at the moment. We'll be back right after this. Thank you, Jono. Well, welcome back to the $5 quiz as we are about to get into the all-important Fast Money round. It is still anyone's game. Are we ready, contestants?
Yes.
All right. Every question is worth 5 points in the Fast Money round, as you know, so we're really upping the ante. Here we go. 60 seconds on the clock, and your time starts now. Puppophobia is a fear of what?
Puppets.
No. Anyone else?
Fathers.
No, puppets. Yes, multiple choice. What is the name of Willie Nelson's legendary guitar? Is it Trigger, Roy, or Horse?
Bong.
That wasn't an option. It's actually Trigger. Who played Christian Grey in 50 Shades of Grey?
Oh, the guy with the beard and the really cute eyes.
5 points for Deborah. Yeah. It was Jamie Dornan. That was close enough. What year was Jurassic Park 1 released?
Ooh. Yes, 1994.
Oh, so close. 1993. 5 points for you. Yes. Yep. Which US state is named on the label of a Jack Daniels bottle? Which US state is named in the late...
Tennessee.
Correct. 5 points. There we go. 15. True or false? Painting was once an Olympic event.
False.
Matt.
False.
Incorrect. It was true. Eating which food before bed is supposed to give you nightmares? Yes.
Cheese.
Correct. 5 points. 4-0. How many seasons of the hit US comedy Friends were made?
New York City.
How many seasons were made? New York City. No, but close.
Green.
Let's have a look now. Deborah on 4, Joe on -12, Sarah on 4, Ivor on -1, Matt on -2, Emily on 0. The winner. Yeah, that's right. The winner is Deborah this morning. Deborah wins the $5. Congratulations to you, Deborah. Emily and Matt, our amazing Australian national swimmers, thank you for joining us on the $5 quiz today. The Australian Swimming Champions wrap up tonight, and you can catch all the action on One from 9:30 p.m. And also, don't forget, Deborah's book, My Love Affair with Food, is out now, and it's an absolute cracker. Do we love it, audience? We've got time for today. Now, will you guys be going home to cook some of Deborah's food, do you think?
Yes, absolutely.
It'll fuel your... Good, that's the correct answer.
You need the protein.
You need the protein.
Can you cook it under water?
No.
I want to show you something. Yep. What you do, is you've got to lean over, because I've put a 5 cent piece under there.
Yes, okay.
And just, are you ready?
Yes.
Ready?
Yep.
Ready?
No.
Lean down forward. Go.
We'll see you soon.